in Crittenden, Kentucky right now to give us a full update. And Brian, I know we've been sharing a lot of your interviews that you've been sending back to us. The woman who I believe was knocking on the door trying to get into that gentleman, I think his name was Brad Huff, trying to get into his home. So kind of tell us what you've heard from people and what you're seeing.
Well, where we've been is in the Harvester neighborhood. And in this subdivision, what you had were a couple of apartment complexes that were basically destroyed by this thing. We have some video, if you could take a look at that. You have probably three or four apartment buildings, some duplexes there that were just really totally destroyed by all this. Fortunately, it told us in this neighborhood about five people were injured here. And at this point, no reports of fatalities, which is amazing when you look at some of these pictures. Now, it wasn't just these complexes. That was the one that was hit the hardest. Windows busted, cars tossed everywhere. Three or four cars just flipped around, looked like they had been a severe accident, like someone had been driving 100 miles an hour and flipped this thing, like something you would see in NASCAR. These things were just tossed by the wind. And this damage was actually over the course of about probably three-quarters of a mile, maybe a mile. We saw a lot of damage, not just to the apartment buildings, but to a number of homes in this area as well. We got there probably a couple of minutes after this storm hit, and as soon as we pulled up, there were people running out of the house. They had their children. They were concerned that the house might collapse. It was so, it had been shaken so violently. There were big holes. We saw a huge hole in the roof and some windows. It looked like debris just went right through these holes. It was strange looking. Generally, you'll see roofs ripped off, which we saw that. But in some places, we saw like huge pieces of debris had gone through the roof as well. So a lot of damage in this area. And again, fortunately, at this point, no reports of death in this area, but there were five injuries. They do not know the extent of those injuries at this hour. This is the command post. We're here as they try and get this area. We're just off of the interstate here, and it's a narrow, winding road leading into that Harvester subdivision, so they're really having a difficult time with all that. What they've done with the people there, there's no electricity down there whatsoever. And so what they've done is they basically evacuated this entire neighborhood. They've taken them over to the Grant County High School. So they're over there tonight. Police are watching this. They have this all taped off, all marked off, and they're running this command center where we are now from this area, which is maybe, you can almost throw a rock and hit the neighborhood from here. So they're all right here. The police are here. But everyone's in darkness or just running generators here to try and keep everything going. So this is still a developing story out here in Crittenden. Sheree?
Brian, it's Kevin Robinson and myself here, and want to talk to you a little bit about some things that, of course, struck us as we're watching this. First of all, talk to us about these families. I mean, it is heartbreaking to see these families. You could just see the fear on their faces as they're grabbing their kids, one mom throwing the little boy in his jammies over her shoulder, just trying to get out of there. They had to have been scared to death.
Yeah, it was pretty frightening, I think, for the kids, for the adults as well. In fact, we talked, that was a Lopez family you saw there. They were bringing their kids out. This was immediately afterward. They weren't really sure what had happened. They were walking out and seeing their neighborhood for the very first time. When they had last seen it, it looked like any neighborhood. When they get out minutes later, it's completely destroyed like this. So you can imagine, very traumatic for the kids. But the parents told us they were actually more shaken up than some of the kids were because it was very traumatic on everyone here. But it was very sad. We talked to a little girl. She said it destroyed my room and I'm so upset. It was really heartbreaking to talk to some of these folks, especially the kids here, Sheree.
Hey, Brian, question for you. Where were these folks? Where did they ride out the storm? I mean, I'm looking at some of this damage, and it's amazing that it's just injuries.
Most of them rode it out in the closets and those internal rooms that we talk about, or we also heard them that were in the basement. And fortunately, you know, when you look at this damage, you see it was fortunate. I will tell you, most of the people told us that they were watching. They were tracking this storm. It still hit them very quickly. This is a good example of how fast this can happen. Most of the people we talk to, and I mean most of them, say, we got into our safe room, into our basement, into our closet, and literally seconds, and this thing hit and started ripping their house apart. In fact, one woman told me they were in her safe room, and she says, I'm holding on to my sister, and she says, my sister told me I can feel the wind, and she goes, we're safe. Stay here. Don't go anywhere. I mean, you know, you think about that in your own home, and that gives you an idea just how chilling this was.
Yeah, and as the parents, you mentioned that the parents are more shaken tonight than the children, because we know the reality of what could have happened and what did happen in some of these communities. Brian, the other thing that I'm looking at there, I'm noticing the firefighters going from home to home, marking X's on the doors. Are they still doing that tonight? And I'm assuming they're doing that to kind of show, we've checked this house, nobody's in here.
In the minutes, in fact, we got into this neighborhood. We were very, must have been pretty close to where this happened. And in fact, there was a truck that was flipped out on the interstate. I suppose it got knocked over by the winds. And we started seeing that. We got basically drove directly into this neighborhood. We got there really before a lot of the crews got there, the emergency crews got there. And we saw them going door to door, knocking to see if everyone was okay, if there was some part of these buildings that had collapsed and they didn't know about, if they needed to rescue people. They were making quick work of going door to door to door. We actually heard on the scanner, they said, we have activated our emergency mode. So they had a procedure. They knew what to do when they got in there. They started marking down roads or looking for down power lines. They're running through these houses, door to door to door, and telling people. And at that time, they thought another storm was on the horizon. They actually told people, look, go back in, get in the lowest part of the house, because there might be another one on the way. Fortunately, that didn't happen. But that was the impression they were under at the time. And that was part of what they were doing, trying to just be safe with the folks. And here were these firefighters walking right down the street, knowing that, you know, there could be another one on the way. They might have to huddle in a house with somebody at that point.
And do they feel like, Brian, they have things under control in the Crittenton area now, that they have people, everyone's accounted for, or are they still searching?
Well, I think at this point, this happened really not long before sundown, and I know what they wanted to do was evacuate that neighborhood. They were still trying to piece together. I talked to them a little bit ago. They were trying to piece together exactly what they had there. You have fire departments down here, you have KSP, you have different police agencies and a number of different fire agencies. They were activating anyone that they could possibly get to come down here and try to help out with this operation, because it is so big. They brought all the school buses down and lined them up along the street going into the apartment complexes and in this whole Harvester neighborhood here. They loaded all those folks onto those buses and started running the buses up to the high school, because it's a fair distance from here. So they had a procedure, and it seemed to be working. I don't know if they're sure yet that everyone is out, but as we walked through the neighborhood, they were in the toughest area and the hardest hit areas. So I think it would be a surprise if it was somebody that hadn't been accounted for. We do know that we saw a number of ambulances up there taking people out. Again, five injured, but you got to remember, when you got a situation like this, you might also have people that, you know, have heart conditions or other medical conditions that are exacerbated by all this, Sheree.
Hey, Brian, I do have one question for you. It's Kevin here. I know it's kind of hard to do with everything being so fluid, but would you happen to have a rough estimate of the number of homes in that community that were damaged or destroyed?
Number of homes. I'm saying probably there were probably six or seven of those multifamily homes. I would say there were probably 50 other homes, I'm guessing, that were in that neighborhood, to give you some idea of the scale of that. So it was probably, this neighborhood is probably 3/4 of a mile long and maybe a 1/2 mile wide, or maybe 3/4 of a mile wide. So you've got, this is a typical, you know, cul-de-sac neighborhood where you've got all these folks. And again, it seemed like there were a lot of people home at this time when this hit. You know, I mentioned it at one point during the day, we saw a lot of people working to get home. It's like they got off work early, or they came home early. So when we got there, there were a lot of people in this neighborhood. We saw a lot of kids there. I mean, a lot of people. This could have been far worse, Kevin.
Wow, wow. Incredible scenes there, Brian. And I think Brian brought up a good point that many people were just making it home.
Exactly. Brian Hamrick reporting live for us tonight. Brian, thank you. He is always...